Hello students, this session we will take up quadratic comparisons. Quadratic comparisons is very important topic for IBPS PO prelim exam, SBA PO prelim exam, IBPS clerk prelim exam, SBA clerk prelim exam, Gramina banks, regional rural banks, officer scale 1, officer scale 2, office assistant, also you take your specialist officer prelim exam. You can expect 5 questions from quadratic comparisons, and this is a scoring area. You cannot miss or you cannot afford to lose marks in this particular topic. Now, what happens in quadratic comparisons? You will be given 2 quadratic equations, one in x form, another in y form. You need to solve both the equations. Quadratic means 2, as all of you know. So, you will get 2 roots. You have to establish a relationship between the roots of x and roots of y. Right, you have to establish a relationship between root of x and roots of y. So x greater than y, x less than y, greater than or equal to y, less than or equal to y, or both are equal, or you cannot establish a relationship. Now let us look at solving these quadratic comparison questions. Now these quadratic comparison questions, first let us look at directions. Each of the following questions, 2 equations numbered 1 and 2 are given. You have to solve both the equations, mark an appropriate answer. Now, maybe in the earlier session when you have seen, I have given the the quadratic comparisons in the order, right? So maybe in the directions, if you can see, the first option you have to mark x greater than y, mark first option, x less than y, mark second option, x greater than or equal to y, third option, less than or equal to y, fourth option. If x and y are equal or you cannot establish a relationship, then you have to mark fifth option. For all the questions, we used to take the same directions and we used to solve. It was there when it was paper-based exam. Now almost all bank exams have become online. In online exams, what happened is, after every question, options are given, but they are jumbled. In the first, let's say first question, first option is x greater than y. This x greater than y in the next question can be in fifth option, it can be in fourth option, it can be in second option, it can be in third option. So students, first you have to solve the equations, get the roots, then you determine the decide the relationship between the roots of x and roots of y, then you see that is present in which of the options, you have to choose that option as your answer. Right? For every question, options are jumbled. That point you have to keep in mind. Now, before we start solving these questions, once again we will revise this. If you look at what is the standard form of quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a not equal to 0, right? A not equal to 0. Now, what happens is, when you look at the standard quadratic equation, you can solve in 2 ways. One, using formula. What is the formula? We all know what is the formula, right? Minus b plus or minus under root b square minus 4ac by 2a. Right? Second one, we can solve this using our factorization method. What is this factorization method? How we do this? Just here, x square plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. Right? Now, what happens here is, you will multiply constant term and x square term. X square into 12. How much x square into 12? 12 x square. That is the first step. You will multiply constant term and x square term. Now, you write middle term as sum of two numbers such that their product is equal to this 12 x square. So, 7x can be written as x square plus 4x plus 3x plus 12 is equal to 0. How much is 4x plus 3x? The sum or difference is equal to middle term. 4x plus 3x is 7x. 4x into 3x is equal to the product, 12x square. 4 into 3 is 12. X into x is 12x square. Now, see, I will take x common from the first two terms. If I take x common, we will get x plus 4. From these two terms, I will take 3 common. We will get x plus 4 is equal to 0. Now, we can take x plus 4 common. X plus 4 into x plus 3 is equal to 0. I can write x is equal to minus 4. Minus 3. These are roots of x. So, one, by using formula method, you have to substitute x square plus 7x plus 12 is equal to 0. Right? This is my quadratic equation. So, what is a value? A value is 1, b value is 7, c value is 12. Substitute here, minus 7 plus or minus b square is 49 minus 4ac. 4 into a is 1 into c is 12, 48 by 2a. 2 into 1 is 2. So, obviously, 49 minus 48 is 1, root 1 is 1. So, minus 7 plus 1 by 2 minus 7 minus 1 by 2, plus or minus, right? So if this is 1, minus 7 plus 1 by 2, minus 7 minus 1 by 2. So minus 6 by 2. This is minus 8 by 2. So obviously minus 3, comma minus 4 are the roots. This is using formula method. Now, formula method is quite time consuming, so we will not use formula method. Now, factorization method you can use. The same factorization method, I'll try to tell you this way. What we do is, this is best method if you are comfortable with your tables. If you are good at your multiplication table, this we keep on telling you every time you prepare for your data interpolation or speed mass, by heart 20 multiplication tables. Now, see, students, how much is we will multiply A into C? Let us say A into C is positive. Now, we have B's, we will have B value, right? Here, coefficient of X is B. Write B as sum of two numbers. If A into C, the product of A into C, what is A? Coefficient of X square and constant term is positive. We will write middle term B, the coefficient of X, B as sum of two numbers. Such that we will add those two, we should get B value. If you multiply those two, we should get the product A into C. In case A into C is negative, if A into C is negative, what will happen? We have to write B as difference of two numbers. We have to write B as difference of two numbers. Such that the difference is equal to B and their product must be equal to A into C. So the same concept which I explained here for factorization method, I am trying to put you in this short form. If you are good at your multiplication table, this would have been a better approach. You will multiply X square coefficient and constant term. If it is positive, the middle term, the coefficient of X, the B value, you will write it as sum of two numbers. Such that their sum is B and product is equal to A into C. If A into C is negative, you write B as difference of two numbers such that their difference is equal to B and their sum is equal to A into C. Now, let us take up the same question here. X square plus 7X plus 12 is equal to 0. How much is A into C? 12. Coefficient of X square, there is nothing, means it is 1, right? So, 1 into 12 is 12. What is my B value? 7. Now, A into C is positive. If A into C is positive, write B as sum of two numbers. So, this 7 can be written as 4 and 3. So, 4 plus 3 is 7. 4 into 3 is 12, right? So, this is equal to 4 plus 3 is 7, it is equal to B, and 4 into 3, the product is equal to A into C, 12. Now, while writing the roots, you have to change the sign. If it is plus 4, it will become minus 4. If it is minus 4, it will become plus 4. So, it is as simple as that. You have to change the sign, you have to write the number. Plus 4 will become minus 4. Divide with X square coefficient. What is X square coefficient here? 1. So, minus 4 by 1, comma, plus 3 will become minus 3, divided by X square coefficient 1. So, obviously the roots are minus 4, comma, minus 3. This would have been a faster approach. Now, let us say, I'll take one more example. X square plus X minus 12 is equal to 0. Now, what is A into C? A into C is minus 12. Coefficient of X square is 1. 1 into minus 12 is minus 12. What is my B value? 1. Now, A into C is negative. When A into C is negative, we have to write B as difference of two numbers. So, the difference of those two numbers should be 1 and their product should be 12. So, what could be those numbers 4 and 3? 4 and 3 difference is 1, but we should get product as how much? Minus 12. And difference as how much? Plus 1. So, what will happen? 4 and minus 3. You should be good at your tables, right? 4 into minus 3 is minus 12. 4 minus 3 is 1. A into C negative, right? B as difference of two numbers. So, 4 and minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1. 4 into minus 3 is 12. While writing roots, what will happen? You have to change the sign. Plus 4 will become minus 4. Divide by coefficient of X square. Don't forget this. If coefficient of X square is 1, no need to divide actually. Minus 3 will become plus 3 by 1. So, what are my roots of X here? Minus 4 comma 3. Right? So, what we do is, we will not use formula anyways, but factorization method also we will try to avoid. The same factorization method we will try to do like this. You will multiply constant term and X square term. Then you write B, the middle term, coefficient of X as sum of two numbers. If A into C is positive, we will write it as sum of two numbers. If A into C is negative, we will write it as difference of two numbers. Right, students? Let us now take up few examples. Now, first question on your screen. X square minus 3X minus 28 is equal to 0. Now, what is A into C? How much? 1 into minus 28 is minus 28. What is my B value? Minus 3. Right? Now, A into C is negative, you have to write B as a difference of two numbers. So, 3 can be written as 7 and 4 difference. 7 and 4 difference is 3, 7 into 4 is 28. But if you observe here, I should get minus 28, I should get minus 3 as the difference. So, what I do is minus 7 comma 4. Minus 7 minus 4. What is the difference here? Minus 7 and plus 4, it is minus 3. Minus 7 into 4 is minus 28. So what will be the roots here? Minus 7 will become plus 7 divided by coefficient of x squared. There is nothing here. So 1. This will be minus 4 by 1. So roots are 7, comma minus 4. What about my second equation? 5y square plus 22y plus 8. A into C, 5 into 8 is 40. B is 22. Right? A into C, 5 into 8, 40. B is 22. Now see, A into C is positive. Write B as sum of two numbers such that their product is 40 and their sum is equal to 22. So how can you write this? Write 20 and 2. Very good. 20 into 2 is 40. 20 plus 2 is 22. While writing the roots, what will happen? You have to change the sign. Plus 20 will become minus 20. And most important point is you have to divide with the coefficient of y square. If there is no coefficient, it will not make any difference to your answer. But if there is coefficient, you have to divide with that. By 5, comma, this will become second one. Plus 2 will become minus 2 by 5. This is 4 times. Minus 4, comma, minus 2 by 5. Now, if you observe here, 7 is greater than these two, right? If you take minus 4 is less than, minus 4 is equal to minus 4. But if you take minus 2 by 5, what is minus 2 by 5? Minus 0.4. In negative terms, the smaller value will be greater. So, minus 4 is less than this. So, we cannot establish a relationship, definite relationship. No relation between roots of x and root of y. Now look at the options. Relationship between x and y cannot be determined. Now, so if you see here, 7 is positive greater than these two. If I take first root, if I take second root, minus 4 is equal to minus 4. Minus 4 is less than minus 0.25. Minus 0.25 is minus 0.4. Negative numbers, smaller value will be greatest, right? So minus 4 is less than minus 0.4. So obviously this is equal, less than or equal to, and this is greater. We don't have we cannot establish a definite relationship. So, choice 5 should be your answer. Question number 2, students. 5x square minus 11x minus 12 is equal to 0. So, how much is A into C? 5 into minus 12 is minus 60. And my B value is minus 11. So, minus 60 means write B as difference of two numbers. 11 can be written as 15 and 4 difference. But we should get minus 60 and minus B as minus 11. So, I will take this as minus 15 comma 4. Minus 15 and into 4 is minus 60. Minus 15 plus 4 is how much? Minus 11. Right? So, what will be my roots here? You have to change the sign. Minus 15 will become plus 15 by 5. And plus 4 will become minus 4 by 5. So, obviously it is 3 comma minus 4 by 5. Right? 3 comma minus 4 by 5. Let us take second equation. A into C, 2 into 27, 54. And B is minus 15. Now, we got A into C as positive. So, write B as sum of two numbers. We'll let it as 9 and 6. 9 into 6 is 54. 9 plus 6 is 15. But we should get minus 15. So, we'll take minus 9 minus 6. Minus 9 minus 6 is minus 15. Minus 9 into minus 6 is plus 54. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Plus 9 by 2. You have to divide with coefficient of y square. Minus 6 will become plus 6 by 2. So, the roots are 3 comma 9 by 2. So, the roots are 3 comma minus 9 by 2. So, what are the roots of x? 3 comma minus 4 by 5. Right? Now, what is the relationship here? If I take 3, 3 and 3 are equal. If you take 3 here, 3 is less than this. 9 by 2 is how much? 4.5. So, 3 less than, the first root is less than or equal to, right? So, if you take minus 4 by 5, it is obvious it is less than this. So, I can say x less than or equal to y. Look at your options given there. X less than or equal to y. We don't have x less than or equal to y. X less than or equal to y is nothing but y greater than or equal to x. Y greater than or equal to x is present in choice 3. Let us take up next question. Question number 3, students. 16x square minus 46x plus 15 is equal to 0. Now, how much is A into C? 15 into 16, 240. You should be thorough with your tables. 15 into 15 is 225, another 15, 240. Or 16 into 16 is 256, remove 16. Or you should know multiplication tables. 15 into 16 is 240, my B value is minus 46. right? So we should get product as 240 and B value is minus 46. So A into C is positive. So write B as sum of two numbers. We'll write it as 40 and 6. 40 into 6 is 240. 40 and 6 is 46, but we should get minus 46. So this should be minus 40 minus 6. Minus 40 minus 6 is minus 46. Minus 40 into minus 6 is plus 240. So while writing the roots, what will happen? Minus 40 will become plus 40 divided by coefficient 16. Minus 6 will become plus 6 by 16. 2 3s, 2 8s. Then here, 8 5s, 8 2s. So 5 by 2 comma 3 by 8. What are x roots? 5 by 2 comma 3 by 8. Now, let us take up second equation. A into C, 10 into 7, 70. B is minus 19. So A into C is positive. So write B as sum of two numbers. So 19 can be written as 14 and 5. 14 into 5 is 70, but we should get minus 19. So this should be minus 14 minus 5. Minus 14 minus 5, if you add, you will get minus 19. Minus 14 into minus 5 is plus 70. So while writing the roots, you will change the sign. Minus 14 will become plus 14 divided by 10, coefficient of y square. Similarly, minus 5 will become plus 5 by 10. 5 by 10 is 1 by 2. 14 by 10 is 2 sevens, 2 fives. So what are y roots? 7 by 5 comma 1 by 2. Now, you have to establish a relationship. 5 by 2 is 2.5. Right, we know 5 by 2 is 2.5, 3 by 8 is how much? 0.375. We know these values, right? 3 by 8 standard reciprocal, 0.375. 5 by 2 is how much? 2.5. Then, how much is 7 by 5? 1.4. How much is 1 by 2? 0.5. Now, if you see a 2.5 is greater than these two, if I take first root 2.5, it is greater than 1.4, it is greater than 0.5. But if I take 0.375, 0.375 is less than 1.4, it is less than this. So, first root is greater than these two, second root is less than these two. So, we cannot establish a definite relationship. So, a relation between x and y cannot be established. Choice 5, students. Question number 4 on your screen. 12x square minus 31x plus 20 is a equal to 0. How much is a into c? 12 into 20? 240. If you are solving simultaneously, please pause the video, solve. Then you check the solution, right? So what is my B value? Minus 31. So A into C is positive, right? B as sum of two numbers. So 240 we should get product and we should get sum as 31. So numbers are 15 and 16. Just now we have seen 15 into 16 in the previous question. 15 into 16 is how much? 240, right? So 15 into 16 is 240. 15 and 16 is 31, but you should get minus 31. So minus 15 minus 16. Minus 15 minus 16 is minus 31. Minus 15 into minus 16 is plus 240, right? So what is x roots now? Minus 15 will become plus 15. You have to change the sign, divided by coefficient 12, comma. Minus 16 will become plus 16 by coefficient of x square is 12. So 4 4s are 16, 4 3s. 3 5 is 3 4. So x value is 5 by 4 roots of x comma 4 by 3. Let us take second equation. 4y square minus 7y plus 3 is equal to 0. How much is a into c? 4 into 3 12. B is how much? Minus 7. So write B as sum of two numbers, 4 and 3. 4 plus 3 is 7. 4 into 3 is 12, but we should get minus 7. B is minus 7. So minus 4 minus 3. Minus 4 minus 3 is minus 7. Minus 4 into minus 3 is plus 12. So while writing the roots, you will change the sign. Minus 4 will become plus 4. You have to divide with coefficient of y square. Minus plus 4 by 4, comma. Minus 3 will become plus 3 by 4. So what are roots of y? Roots of y are 1, comma 3 by 4. Now see here, 5 by 4, 4 by 3. These two are greater than 1 only value. 5 by 4 is 1.25, 4 by 3 is 1.33, these are greater than 1. Now, here we have either 1 or 3 by 4 is 0.75, it is less than 1. So, 1 or less than 1, it is greater than 1, both the roots. So, obviously, clearly, x roots are greater than y roots, x greater than y. X greater than y is present in which option? X greater than y is nothing but we can say y less than x. So, it is first option, students. Question number 5, it is very simple, it is not a quadratic equation, but sometimes you will come across linear equations also in quadratic comparisons, right? Now simple, what you do is, you will add these two. If you add these two, 4x plus 7x, 11x is equal to 28 plus 16 is 44, x value is 4. Now substitute x value here, 16, so 3y is equal to 28 minus 16, that is equal to 12, 3y is equal to 12. Y is equal to 4. So x and y both are equal. It is present in fourth option. It is a very simple question, students. Question number 6, students, on your screen. 25x square plus 35x plus 12 is equal to 0. How much is a into c? 25 into 12, it is 300. Right? What is my b value? 35. A into c is positive. So, write b as sum of two numbers. This 35 can be written as, you have to good at your multiplication tables, 20 and 15. 20 plus 15 is 35. 20 into 15 is 300. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Plus 20 will become minus 20 divided by coefficient of x square 25. Plus 15 will become minus 15 by 25. 5 threes, 5 fives, 5 fours, 5 fives. So, x value is minus 4 by 5, comma minus 3 by 5. These are roots of x. Now, let us take up y. A into c, it is simple. 8 into 1 is 8 and b value is 6. A into c is positive. Write b as sum of two numbers. So, 4 and 2. 4 plus 2 is 6. 4 into 2 is 8. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Plus 4 will become minus 4 divided by coefficient of y square, that is 8. Plus 2 will become minus 2 divided by coefficient of y square is 8. Minus 2 by 8 is 1 by 4. Minus 4 by 8 is 1 by 2. So, what are y roots, students? Minus 1 by 2, comma, minus 1 by 4. Right. It is, you need to be a little careful. You know, 3 by 5 value, 3 by 5 value is how much? 0.6. So, this minus 0.6. 4 by 5 is 0.8, minus 0.8. Now, how much is this? 1 by 2, minus 0.5. 1 by 4, minus 0.25. We know that negative numbers, whenever it is negative values, smaller value will be always greater. Now, 0.5, obviously 0.8 is less than 0.5, less than 0.25. 0.6, less than 0.5, less than 0.25. Clearly, x less than y. X less than y is present in which option? X less than y, second option, students. Seventh question. Right, x square minus, don't get what you call nervous, you have just roots here, just here, how much is x square minus, minus of 3 plus root 6 into x plus 3 root 6, how much is a into c value, we should get 3 root 6 if you multiply, and what is b value, minus of 3 plus root 6, right, we should get negative of 3 plus, that means minus 3 minus the root 6 we should get. Now, a into c is positive, so write b as sum of two numbers, we will write it as 3 root 6. 3 into root 6 is 3 root 6 and sum is 3 plus root 6, but we should get minus sign here. So, we will take minus 3 minus root 6. Minus 3 minus root 6, if you multiply minus into minus is plus 3 root 6. If you add minus 3 plus minus root 6 is minus 3 minus root 6, I can take minus common, it will be 3 plus root 6. If I take minus common when we add. So, while writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Minus 3 will become plus 3 divided by coefficient of x square. There is nothing here. So, plus 3 comma minus root 6 will become plus root 6. So, 3 comma root 6. Now, second equation, y square plus 2 minus root 6 into y minus 2 root 6 is equal to 0. A into c is minus 2 root 6 and b value is how much? 2 minus root 6. Now, a into c is negative. You have to write b as difference of two numbers. So, I will write it as 2 minus root 6. Now, if we multiply, we will get minus 2 root 6. If we add, we will get 2 minus root 6. So, while writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Plus 2 will become minus 2 coefficient of y square. There is no coefficient of y square. So, we will write it as 1. So, plus 2 will become minus 2. Minus root 6 will become plus root 6. So, 3 comma root 6 minus 2 comma root 6. Now, if I take here 3, obviously it is more than minus 2, negative value. And 3 is greater than 6 also. Because what is root 9 value? Root 9 value is 3. So, don't find out root 6 value. Root 6 value will be obviously less than 3. So, 3 is greater than minus 2, it is greater than root 6. So, clearly it is greater than these two roots. What about root 6? Root 6, root 6 are equal. But when you see a root 6, it is negative value. Obviously, root 6 is positive. It is greater than or equal to. Sorry, root 6 is greater than or equal to. So, 3 is greater than these two. Root 6 is, root 6 are equal. But if you take negative value, root 6 is positive, it is greater. So, what is the relationship? X is greater than or equal to y. X greater than or equal to y, it is present in fourth option, students. Eighth question. X square minus 16x plus 60 is equal to 0. How much is a into c? 60. How much is b value? Minus 16. So, a into c is positive. So, write b as how much? Sum of two numbers. Their product must be 60 and b value, their sum must be equal to 16. Right? So, 60 can be written as what? 10 and 6, 10 plus 6 is 16, 10 into 6 is 60, but we should get minus 16, so I'll take minus 10 minus 6, minus 16, minus 10 into minus 6 is plus 60. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign, minus 10 will become plus 10, minus 6 will become plus 6. There is no coefficient of y square, it's only one here, coefficient of x square, so no need to divide, students. Now, second equation you take, a into c, y square minus 22y plus 112 is equal to 0, a into c is 112. What is my b value? Minus 22. Now friends, a into c is positive, so we have to write b as sum of two numbers such that their product is 112, sum is 22. We will write it as 14 and 8. You should be good at your multiplication tables. 14 into 8 is 112, 14 plus 8 is 22, but I should get minus 22. So it should be minus 14 minus 8. Minus 14 minus 8 is minus 22. Minus 14 into minus 8 is nothing but plus 112. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Minus 14 will become plus 14 divided by coefficient of y square. We have only 1 here. So 14 by 1 is 14 and 8 by 1 is 8. So what are the roots here? 10, 6, 14, 8. 10, if you take, it is less than 14, it is greater than 8. If you take 6, it is less than these two. So here one root is 10, if I take, it is less than 14, but it is greater than 8. So one is less, one other is great. So we cannot establish a definite relationship. No relationship, we will say choice fair. Relationship cannot be, we are not getting a definite relationship. Relationship cannot be established. So choice 5. It is not x equal to y. Relationship between x and y cannot be established. Let us take up ninth question, students. 49x square minus 7x minus 6 is equal to 0. How much is a into c? Minus 294. 49 into 6 is minus 294 because 50 into 6 is 300. 49 into minus 6, remove 160, it is 294. So minus 294, comma, b value is equal to minus 7. A into c is negative. So write b as difference of two numbers. Right? Write b as difference of two numbers. So this can be written as 21, 14. 21 into 14, 294. 21 and 14, difference is 7, but we should get minus 7. And we should get minus 294. So minus 21 comma 14. Minus 21 into 14 is minus 294. Minus 21 plus 14 is minus 7. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Minus 21 will become plus 21 divided by coefficient of x square 49. And plus 14 will become minus 14 divided by coefficient of x square is 49. 7 2s, 7 7s, 7 3s, 7 7s. So what is roots of x here? 3 by 7 comma minus 2 by 7. 3 by 7 comma minus 2 by 7. Now, let us take second equation. 7y square minus 17y plus x plus 6 is equal to 0. How much is a into c? 7 into 6, 42. How much is b value? Minus 17. Right? Now, a into c is positive. Write b as sum of two numbers. 17 can be written as 14 and 3. 14 plus 3 is 17. 14 into 3 is 42. But we should get minus 17. So, minus 14 minus 3. Minus 14 minus 3. If you add minus 17, minus 14 into minus 3 is plus 42. While writing the roots, you have to change the sign. Minus 14 will become plus 14 divided by coefficient of y square. What is coefficient of y square? 7. Minus 3 will become plus 3 by 7. So, what are the roots here? 2 comma 3 by 7. Now, y is 2 comma 3 by 7. Right? Now, if you observe here, 3 by 7, 3 by 7, these two are equal. 3 by 7, it is less than 1, it is 2. So clearly, x, the first root, if you take it, is less than or equal to second roots of y. If you take minus 2 by 7, clearly it is negative value. It is less than these two roots. So less than if I take second root. If I take first root, it is less than or equal to y roots. So what is the definite relationship? X less than or equal to y. X less than or equal to y is present in third option. Question number 10. 52x square minus 37x minus 35 is equal to 0. Second equation, 45y square minus 22y minus 16 is equal to 0. Now, the point here is, when the numbers are bigger numbers, then don't try to see. The point is, you try to see if there is any common factor. There is no common factor, 52, 37, 35. Now, don't try to use factorization method or don't try to use formula also. It will be time consuming, right? Even a into c, what is, how much is a into c? 52 into minus 35. Now it will also consume certain time. This equation particularly, if you ask me in the examination, how will you solve this? Now see here, what are my product of roots? Product of roots is c by a, right? So c value is minus 35 by a value is 52. Now see here, what is my product of roots here? In the second case, product of roots is c by a. It is also minus 16 by 45. C value is minus 16. A value is 45. Here minus 35 by 52. Don't focus on the value. What is my product of roots here? Product of roots is negative in both the cases. If product of roots is negative, what will happen? There are two roots, right? One will be positive, other will be negative. One will be positive, other will be negative. See, the product of roots, two roots, right? You have two roots. Product of roots is positive. Then what will happen? There are two cases. Both the roots can be positive or both the roots can be negative. Depending on sum of roots, we can answer the question. But if you observe here, product of roots negative. That means in the first equation, one root is positive, other is negative. In the second equation, one root is positive, other is negative. Now what will happen if I take this positive root? Positive root is greater than this negative root. If I take this negative root is less than. That means one root will be greater, other root will be less. So we clearly see we cannot establish any relationship. No relationship. Choice 5 should be your answer using shortcut. No relationship. You understood? Product of the roots in both the cases is negative. If product of roots is positive, two numbers product is positive means both of them should be positive or both of them should be negative. Then I can't say anything. But in this case, what happened? You have to consider sum of roots there. But in this case, what is happening? Product of roots negative. So if the product is negative means one root should be positive, other should be negative. In both the cases, product of roots is negative. So in first case also, one root is positive, other is negative. Second also, one is positive, other is negative. Now if I take positive root here, if I take negative root here, it will be greater. Now in this case, if you take negative root here, positive root here, it will be less. So one case it is greater, other case it is clearly less, irrespective of values. I am saying one positive value is greater than negative value here, negative value here is less than positive value here. So I cannot establish a definite relationship. In case you would like to find out roots, not required, I am saying using the shortcut we can answer. In case if you want to find out the roots here, how much is a into c? 52 into minus 35. Right now, how much is B value? Minus 37. So A into C is, I'll just don't multiply, just take the factor minus of 52 is how much? 4 into 13. 35 can be written as 5 into 7. We should write negative, right? So B we are getting minus 37. A into C is negative. So we have to write B as difference of two numbers. So what we do is 13 5s are 65, 7 4s are 28. 65, 28. So, we should get 65 plus 20, 65 into 28, we'll get this product. Minus 65 comma 28, if you add, we'll get minus 37. So, writing the roots, minus 65 will be plus 65 divided by coefficient of x square 52. My plus 28 will be minus 28 by 52. Right? 4 sevens, 4 thirteens. Not required, just for understanding, if the number is big, what you need to do is 5 by 4 comma minus 7 by 13 at the roots. Similarly, here, how much is a into c? 45 into minus 16. 45 into minus 16. What is my B value? I should get minus 22. Now, A into C is, I can write this as minus of 5 into 9, right? Into 16 is 4 into 4, right? So, this again, this can be written as minus 5 into 3 into 3. I'm writing into prime factors. 2 into 2, again 2 is 2 into 2. Now, I should get B as minus 22, right? We should get B as minus 22, A into C is negative, right? So we should write B as difference of two numbers. Now if you observe here, 5 into 2, 10 into 2, 20 into 2, 40. So 40, you see here 3 into 3, 9, 9, 2s are 18. If you write factorization, it will be easy to find out the numbers, right? We should get 40 and 18 difference is 22 because A into C is negative, difference should be equal to B. But you should get minus 22 means minus 40 comma 18. Minus 40 plus 18 is minus 22, minus 40 into 18 is, we'll get this product, right? So while writing the roots, what will happen? Minus 40 will become plus 40 divided by coefficient of y square 45. This will become minus 18 by 45. So minus 2 by 5. This will be how much? 8 by 9. This is what I am trying to say. Negative root, positive value is greater than this. Negative value is less than this. So I cannot establish a proper relationship. Choice 5 should be your answer. So in case if you want to find out how to find out the roots of bigger numbers, you will prime factorize them, then try to see which numbers will get me that sum of the two numbers, which is sum of B or difference of sum of these two numbers or difference of two numbers, depending on A into C is positive or negative. Right, student? This is how you need to solve your quadratic comparison equations. Now, I try to explain fast because you need to be so fast in exam. Right? You can't think for each question. So you can't take so much of time, then think, then try to answer the question. You don't have so much of time. If you want to practice this method, you have to be good at your multiplication tables. Learn multiplication tables. It is going to help you out. So, friends, this is how you need to solve these questions, students. Now, Hope you understood and clear. You have to practice more number of quadratic equations of this type, then you will get that familiarity with the numbers. Learn multiplication tables, practice quadratic comparisons. You cannot afford to lose mark in this quadratic comparisons. Each and every mark is important. Once there are 5 questions, you need to get 5 out of 5 in your examination. Right, students, we'll stop here. Thank you so much. So hope you understood this session. Stay home, stay safe, prepare with time classes. Thank you, students.